Now we already discussed the involute profile, its analysis and all, we already discussed. And we can say that the profiles which follow the law of gearing are known as conjugate profile, and conjugate profile is of two types. One is the involute profile, another one is the cycloidal profile. So cycloidal profile only, just a brief introduction we are dealing with. So the cycloidal profile is also a conjugate profile. That means this cycloidal profile will also satisfy your law of gearing, right? It is also a conjugate profile. Now, how to draw the cycloidal profile? We already see that in case of involute profile, the involute profile is a locus of a point on a line if that line is under pure rolling on a fixed circle, right? Similarly, we can say that the cycloidal profile, if we reverse the condition, the cycloidal profile is the locus of a point on the circumference of a circle which rolls without slipping on a fixed straight line, right? In the cycloidal profile, in the involute profile, circle is fixed, line is under rolling, but in cycloidal profile, your line is fixed and circle is under pure rolling. And we can say that the if I consider a point on the circumference of that circle, so if I trace the movement, trace the position of that point, when this circle will be under pure rolling on that fixed line, then the profile which we got is known as conjugate profile. Now you can see from here, suppose this is a fixed line and this is one circle, right? I am showing different circles with different color at different position, right? Suppose this white color circle is the first one initially, right? So this is the second, after some time, this is the after some more time. So this circle, white circle, is under pure rolling like this, right? I am showing like this. Suppose I am considering a point on this circle. Let us say I am considering a point on this circle. Suppose this point, right? So we can say that if this is a point, then I will say, suppose this is a point. Now if when the circle will reach at this point, let us say this point will come here, and this point will come at this point in this yellow circle, this point will come at this point in this circle, and this point will come at this point in this circle. So if we trace the position of this point when these circles are in pure rolling, and if I join all these points, then the profile which you got is known as cycloidal profile, and this profile is also a conjugate profile. That means that it can satisfy the law of gearing. Now suppose if I can say that if instead of this fixed line, if I take a fixed circle, this is also known as base circle, and suppose one circle is under pure rolling at the top of this and one circle is under pure rolling at the inside this fixed circle, right? This circle is under pure rolling in the inside surface and this circle is under pure rolling on the top surface. So this circle will generate a profile. And if you consider a point on this, the locus of that point will generate a profile that is known as hypocycloid. And when this circle is under pure rolling on this fixed circle, and if I take a point on the circumference of this circle, and if I trace the position of that point, so the profile generated by this above circle is known as epicycloid. Right, so as a result, we will get, let us say, this type of tooth profile, right? So the portion of the tooth above the base circle, above this fixed circle, is known as face, and this portion below the base circle, this is known as flank. So this is your cycloidal teeth. Now you can see from here, one thing you notice, that in this case of cycloidal profile, the profile which is above the base circle, this one, this profile is also cycloid because it is come out of this rolling motion of this cylinder or circle, and this profile which is below the base circle, this is also cycloid. This is also cycloid because this is also come from this circle, this rolling motion of this circle. So both of these profiles are the cycloidal profile. So if there is the point of contact of the mating gear on this anywhere on the face or on the flank, your law of gearing will satisfy because the complete profile is the cycloidal profile. That is not true with the involute. In case of involute, we can say that the profile above the base circle is only involute. The profile which is below the base circle is not involute. But here, above the base circle or below the base circle, both profile will be cycloidal and both will be conjugate. Now let us discuss what is the advantage of using this cycloidal profile. That most important advantage is that there is no interference. Why there is no interference? The first one is, the first condition for interference, we can say, suppose we already see that, let us say this is the involute teeth, right? This is the involute teeth, and if I draw a cycloidal teeth on this, so the cycloidal teeth will be like this. Sorry. Cycloidal teeth will look like this. This will be the cycloidal tooth, kind of this. So you can see that in the cycloidal tooth, already you have this undercut. There is no need to provide this undercut, but already you have this undercut. So one reason is this, that you have a undercut. But the most important reason is there, that in the cycloidal tooth, the face and the flank, both profile are the cycloidal profile, right? But in case of your involute, the profile which is above the base circle is only involute. The below the base circle profile is not involute. So here, if the teeth of the mating gear will touch at any point, let us say touch at this point, then also your law of gearing is satisfied. Then there should not be any interference. So in the cycloidal profile, no interference will be there. This is the most important advantage. Second is, we can say that in this case we have wide flank. Your flank is wide, right? So that we can say that the teeth will be stronger, and obviously this gear will have more life, because if you can see that it is a concave convex portion, right? It is a concave convex portion, and suppose the mating teeth will come like this. The mating teeth will be like this. This will be the mating teeth, right? This will be the mating gear teeth. So if I draw it correctly, suppose let us say this is the teeth of one gear, and on this, let us say one teeth will be in contact of another gear. So the another gear teeth will be like this only, you know. Right, I'm just drawing the another gear teeth will be look like this. Oh, another gear tooth will be look like this, which will be come in contact with this gear at this point, let us say. So we have concave convex connection, and if we have concave convex connection, obviously the life will be more because wear and tear will be very less. But the major problem with the, if we talk about cycloidal profile, is this, that its pressure angle is not constant. As we discussed earlier, in the involute profile, in any case, in the involute profile, your pressure angle is constant, right? Pressure angle is constant, but in case of this cycloidal profile, your this pressure angle is not constant, right? So when the engagement is start, so at the engagement, at the start of the engagement, the value of this pressure angle is maximum. When the point of contact is at pitch point, this pressure angle will be zero. And when the point of contact is at the end of engagement, then we can say that its value will be again maximum. This maximum will be in opposite direction, in opposite direction to this start of engagement face angle, right? So we can say that at the start and at the end of the engagement, the pressure angle will be having maximum value, but at the pitch point, the pressure angle will be zero. So this pressure angle is changing in case of cycloidal profile, but in case of involute profile, it will remain constant. But you can say that, sir, if there is no interference in the cycloidal profile, then this cycloidal profile is the best profile, because if there is no interference, then there should not be any condition of minimum number of teeth. So we can transmit the power with the less number of teeth. If there is a less number of teeth, then this gear can be easily manufactured. The cost of this gear will be very less. So why we are not using the cycloidal profile in any gear? If you see, the maximum will we are using involute profile, because the disadvantage with this profile is, this is the best profile if we can use it, but the disadvantage is that it will not maintain the constant velocity ratio. It will not maintain the constant velocity ratio if your center distance will change. If this over O2, this center distance will change, it will not maintain the constant velocity ratio. And you know that this center distance will change because of vibrations. Vibrations we cannot minimize up to zero. You cannot make these vibrations zero. Vibrations will always be there. We will study in case of your vibration chapter that you cannot make the vibrations completely zero. Some vibrations will always be there. So because of that vibration, that this center distance will continuously change. And in the involute profile, the advantage of the involute profile is, if you are changing the center distance, then also it will maintain the constant velocity ratio. But this cycloidal profile will not maintain the constant velocity ratio in case of your change of center distance. This is the most disadvantage of this profile. That's why if we are able to make zero vibration in the system, then obviously you have to use the cycloidal profile. No concept of involute profile will be there. But vibrations cannot be zero, then we have to use involute profile. Interference phenomena will be there in involute, and you can avoid the interference with the minimum number of teeth, but you have to use the involute profile, because if the center distance will change, then the constant velocity ratio can be given by the involute only, then this cycloidal profile will not help you. So this is all about the chapter of gears, right? This is all about the chapter of gears as we are talking about the gate syllabus.